just so much fun because we've got, there's new faces and there's longtime friends and fans that I think you know more than anybody how excited we are this morning to be cutting a ribbon and welcoming the world into yet another just grand expansion of the Elvis legacy and the Graceland campus. And anyway, we can't wait for you to come in and to see the new exhibit areas, the new restaurants, the new the new everything, and the tour of Graceland, because we've moved so much of the Elvis the Entertainer into its own home, the racquetball building, the trophy building in at Graceland. Hopefully, you're all touring today. Everybody's touring, and so I think you'll find it very special. So anyway, just welcome, thank you, friends, new friends, longtime friends. We hope you're excited as we are. And now I want to invite, this has been made possible. It's been one thing for us to have dreams and aspirations and goals, but you know, it took a tremendous amount of commitment in resolve and money, the financial wherewithal to a beautiful hotel off in the distance, and now just a few months later, this new complex, Elvis Presley's Memphis, and it's been made possible by the commitment of the guy I'm going to introduce, and that's our managing partner, Joel Weinschenker. Joel, thank you.
Yay. Hello. So Elvis Presley loved Memphis. He loved everything about Memphis. He loved Graceland. Elvis had and has hundreds of millions of fans, and he treated each fan like a friend. He welcomed him to his home, took him to the movie, if you remember. You know, took him to the movie theater here in Memphis, and obviously Priscilla can talk to you about that. He gave gifts to thousands and thousands and thousands of fans, and, you know, someone asked me yesterday what was the greatest thing I think I brought to the process. And my greatest idea was a simple one. What would Elvis do for his fans and his friends? Because they're the same. And what he would do is he'd build a guest house for them. He'd be able to build something that where he'd be able to show all his friends, people would be able to walk with Elvis in his footsteps. And what you're going to see today is the beginning of a new era at Graceland, where when you walk through the mansion, you're walking in his footsteps. You're looking at the mansion in such close proximity to the way that Elvis did the day he passed away. You're going to be able to walk through the streets of his Memphis, which is right here at Graceland, Elvis Presley's Memphis. And you're going to be able to see all the things that he loved and the things that he shared with his friends. You know, Priscilla got him into horseback riding. Suddenly all of his friends had horses. Loved motorcycles. Suddenly all of his friends had motorcycles. Elvis never, anything that Elvis loved to do, the first thing he thought about was sharing it with his friends. And today, we're going to be able to share with all of his friends here. And even the 20 million people who have already visited Graceland, if you haven't visited Graceland lately, you haven't visited Graceland. So, and obviously this place and the hotel wouldn't be possible if it wasn't for Priscilla Presley. So I'd like to introduce Priscilla.
Hello, everyone. Wow, it's hard to believe we're here again with another exciting, complex that we've been wanting to do again for so many, many years to make this a better visitor experience. And here you'll be able to, as Joel has just said, and I won't repeat because he did a beautiful job, you'll be able to go through and see the things that we've been wanting to show for many, many, many years. But we didn't have the room for it, and that's we have the warehouses filled with memorabilia, filled with memories actually that now we're able to show you and the fans and all the visitors and new visitors and old ones, as Jill said, they'll come back and get to see all the things that we had, or most of the things in our warehouses. So I think this is a very exciting time. It is true what Joel said, that Elvis was so generous, so gracious, a very giving artist, a very giving man. And that's one of the questions that people ask me, was Elvis truly so generous? Was he really that giving? And yes, he was. He always thought that, you know, he would love to share the things that he was able to accomplish to get in his lifetime with his fans, and even give them gifts, which he did. So we're able to express even more who Elvis Presley was by what you see today. His car collection is unbelievable. He was the king of fashion, and you see his clothes and his what he wore. He was so unique in his style. You'll see artists that he influenced. Many artists were in collaboration with about 25 artists and celebrities who Elvis, as we all know, paved the pathway to singers and even actors. So you'll get to see all of that. You'll see the Sam Phillips exhibit in partnership with his family. How it all started with Sun Records. You take that journey. We're all very, very proud of this complex. And even the movie theater, and even a 20,000 square foot complex where you could have concerts. 2,000 people, maybe you will have entertainment here and bring that to Memphis as well. So I hope you enjoy this complex. We're very proud of it. It's been, oh my gosh, Jack, how long have we wanted to do this? I mean, forever. And, you know, Elvis and I were in the front of Graceland, the front steps on the foyer looking out. And one of the things he did not like was looking across the street and seeing all the retail that had happened while he was in the Army. Because when he left here, all this was greenery, all this was trees, even the apartments that were here a long time ago, which are gone today because we've taken over the area. But he said it was heartbroken that so many people had started moving here. He wanted to buy more property. We had 13 acres. He wanted his father to come back and get more property. That didn't happen because while he was gone, the area started building up. But this area across the street, what he wanted to see was greenery. And we'll get rid of all of that eventually in the front, and that'll all come back to the time when he was able to look across and it'll be all green again. So to be able to fulfill these dreams is such a pleasure to all of us at EPE who knew what those dreams were. And you'll see it today through his life and take the journey. So thank you so much for coming this evening. Or this today, actually. I'm sorry, evening. Late night last night. So to come today and enjoy it. And thank you for coming. Thank you so much. Yay!
All right. Yes, these are the...
These
are
the same scissors that cut the
opening of Graceland. So here's another great one. Move! All right, and in 3, 2, 1. And real quick, we'll have Jack, Joel, and Priscilla pause real brief for a photo op. Thank you, Jack, Joel, and Priscilla. We appreciate it. And for all of you visitors and the press, we do have some housekeeping notes. These massive scissors that we've just used to cut the ribbon, we're actually going to have along the railing here, so you, the visitors, can actually pose with the scissors that were used to cut Elvis Presley's Memphis in front of this beautiful sign. And then directly in front of you is the ticketing area where you can purchase your tickets to tour Elvis Presley's Memphis and Graceland today. In terms of the media, we're going to allow you guys to move forward and shoot some exteriors, and if you'll come meet